Now, I want to make it clear, I don't hate George Bush. Do you hate him?
Yes!
Always some haters. I don't hate him. Every time I try to listen to him and I find that I can't hear him because there's somebody screaming and it turns out it's me. And I have a theory about the whole Bush administration that it's one vast, well-orchestrated conspiracy to make Nixon look rational. And it's working. Nixon looks rational. Reagan looks fiscally responsible. Dan Quayle looks like a genius. And I've begun to feel sorry for Bush. No, I have, because we've all had jobs we weren't qualified for. We've all taken bad advice. We've all given an impromptu back rub to the Chancellor of Germany. Who hasn't? So I say, lay off. He waved to Stevie Wonder. Remember? Gave everyone a stupid name. And when he did, I laughed and called him idiot. But now I see him clearly, and my heart is filled with shame. The words my mama said keep ringing in my head. She told me, don't make fun of the crippled boy. He's had it bad enough. His case is sad enough already. Don't mock his cranium full of air. It isn't nice, it isn't fair. Don't point and stare at the crippled boy. 'Cause after all, he's the decider. And that's not even a friggin' word, so what you gonna do? He's the uniter, not a divider. And with approval ratings hovering at 2, I guess that's true. He can't help his handicap. He's like a man decapitated. Just make him happy for a while. When he says nuclear, just smile. Don't be Bush bashing. Spare the lash and have a ration of compassion for the crippled boy.